what's up, everybody? Jason here. Today, I want to talk to you about some dumb rules and how they can stop you from getting fired. This is actually a really important topic and something that I've been kind of putting off talking about for a while because it involves a confession of something really stupid that I did in the past. But I think it's important enough to cover and that everybody should kind of understand why some of these dumb rules exist, what they're there for, and what benefits you can get out of them. Let's begin with a little story time first, though. I want to tell you the story of how, well, lack of rules, or really lax rules, led to me doing something that could have been relatively disastrous and could have been a really big mistake. So let's just get into it. At the time, I was working at Sony Online Entertainment. It's a company that's made a bunch of big MMOs. You've probably seen EverQuest. It was one of the first big giant ones. I didn't get to work on that one much, but I did get to work on EverQuest 2 and Vanguard, which I actually have posters up all around my office of. It's one of my favorite games and the one that, well, I made this big mistake. When I started on the Vanguard team, the size was around 100 and something people. It was a little over 100 people with like 30 engineers. We had a separate database team with a database administrator and a whole set of management and rules and processes. At the time of this mistake, though, things had scaled down dramatically. Most of the people had moved over to other projects. I was very into the game, so did not want to move at all and stayed there. But the team shrunk down, and we might have been down to like 10 people on the team at that time, with no solo database administrator, nobody really running the management of infrastructure and stuff outside of the separate, totally separate infrastructure team that ran our live production stuff. So all of our internal stuff, our test servers, our QA stuff, all of that was kind of managed by us, and I somewhat had access to manage a little bit of that to keep it going so that we could keep our servers up and running and maintained as we needed it. Now, this is where the problem came in. I also had access to our development server. Now, development server on these games, at least on a lot of the Sony MMOs and a lot of MMOs that I've worked on, it's got a database where all of the content is stored, and then it's got another database where all of the persistent stuff is stored. So all of the characters, think of like their items, their money, which we'll get into in just a moment, their level, their experience, and all that stuff is all stored in a database. Now, on our development database, we'd often just go in there and make direct changes. So we could go in there and, you know, change somebody's items, change somebody's inventory, or items are kind of a rare one, but sometimes just go like delete out all their items. Imagine like we're doing development, so sometimes we get like bugged items in there or bugged other data in there, and we just got to go straight into the database, delete that stuff out, change it, and make updates. So in general, most of the developers had at least some level of access to the development database, assuming that they wouldn't make big giant mistakes, and we had hourly backup, so if somebody somehow did make a big giant mistake, we could undo it. At the time, though, I also had that same access to the test database. And while we were working on things, I needed to make a small change to test something out on the test server. And on the test server, it was this weird setup where we had access to the database, but we did not have exact access or full permissions to do everything that we needed to do from the command line. Now, we could theoretically go about the process of increasing our permissions and then doing the command in game, but we'd often just kind of shortcut things. And really, we just shortcutted them because it was like a one-off thing that we needed to do randomly that we didn't regularly do. Very rare that we would work on the test server. So in general, we tried to keep the permissions low, but occasionally we'd need to get around it. So what happened was I'm working on the test server and we needed to test something with money. I forget what the actual bug was, but we just needed to set some money back down to zero or set it back up to an amount and keep doing a couple of changes testing money. And if you're a database administrator or you've worked in databases at all, you can probably already guess what happened next. I'm writing out my SQL statement to update the coins on one character. I think it was the designer's test character. Got it in there like, hey, set coins equal coin equals 1000, where the name equals this, except I forgot the where part. Now, if you're not familiar with SQL queries, if you leave off the where clause on a statement, it actually just runs against every row in the database. So if you say update the table, set coin equals 1000, it's going to set every player's coin to 1000. Now, had this been a production server, it would have been a giant nightmare and a disaster. Luckily, it was a test server, and it was a very low activity test server with maybe a dozen or so people on it at a time. So it ended up being, well, not career ending, but had it been something else, this one little mistake could have been a giant disaster. It could have, at the very least, stunted my career and caused me giant problems. And I'm just really, really, really thankful that I learned this lesson in this way, so that it didn't come out in like a big situation where things kind of fell apart. So what came out of this? I guess first I wasn't able to completely fix the data. I just updated everybody, gave everybody a reasonable amount of money and called it good. Said, hey guys, screwed up. I made this change. I accidentally ruined everybody's money. I'm just going to set everybody's money to this amount. Does that seem like an okay fix? Talked about it a little bit, fixed it. Everything was good. But the lesson that I learned here, two of the biggest lessons. One was that when I'm writing SQL statements, I always just write them with a begin transaction and a rollback and put everything in the middle, run it many, many, many times until I'm done and think it's good before I'll put a commit in there. If you're not familiar with SQL, don't worry. It's essentially just testing it out, doing like a test run until you're finally good and then committing it. Also, when I'm working with SQL, what I prefer to do and what is generally recommended is that I will write all of the scripts out, prepare it, run all of that testing, and then give it to a database administrator who actually has permissions on those servers. When it comes to any production servers, I always just refuse access. I don't want it. They don't give me access to the production servers, not the database, not the deployment environment, not anything else. Unless, of course, I absolutely need it. If we're in a small startup, and I'm the one that's responsible for doing the deployment, sure, give me that access, but let's set it up on a separate account so that we've got totally separate access levels and it's very hard to accidentally make a mistake and do something. But in general, if I don't need the access, I refuse it. I don't know how to say it right, but I just do not take it. I don't want it. Don't give it to me. Because even if I don't do anything wrong, right? Even if I make no mistakes, somebody hacks into my system, they get into the thing and break it. I don't know. Somebody figures out my password somehow. My password's generally super secure, but hey, maybe it's not in that case. And they get in, or maybe they're watching it or something. Somebody somehow gets into my account or something else goes wrong. I don't want to be associated with anything on the production server unless I absolutely need to. And I highly recommend this to everybody else. And I know that it's tempting, like, when you're working on a game, you're like, oh man, if I had access to just be able to push out a new build live right now, whenever I wanted, I could fix all of these issues and stuff. And yeah, you can. You can get this direct access to push out changes and make changes really, really fast and rapidly. But if there's not some process there watching it and making sure that no mistakes are made, you'll end up being responsible when you make the mistake. So I'd say minimize the opportunity to make these mistakes. You know, don't give yourself too much permissions or refuse as much permission as possible. And not just for databases too. Remember, don't get permissions for deployment if you don't need them. Don't get user access or access to user stuff like GM permissions or permissions to change stuff for players. Definitely, whatever you can do, avoid getting access to any user or customer payment info. Like, that's something that I will do everything I can to avoid. I don't want to be responsible for it. It's a big legal liability and just a big mess. So avoid that kind of stuff and just let the people who are responsible for that stuff deal with it and don't try to take it on yourself. I know that, at least for me, now this may not be the case for you. If it's not for you, hey, let me know in the comments. But if you were a developer like me who, when you started out, just really hated the fact that you didn't have access to everything, also let me know. I'm kind of curious, like, was I just a weirdo that wanted to be able to do everything and thought, hey, if I just had access to all of these production servers, I could do amazing things and everything would be great. I could do it so much faster without all this stuff slowing me down. I'm curious. Is it just me? Maybe I am just crazy. It's certainly possible. Anyway, I hope this was somewhat helpful and I hope it's helpful to anybody watching this. So make sure that you like, subscribe, and share the video. If so, also, if you like the weird new camera angle that I've got set up here, make sure that you let me know in the comments too, because I'm kind of curious about it. It seems kind of neat, but I don't know how I feel about it. All right, thanks again, everybody, for watching, and I'll see you soon.